I started listening to soundtracks, and I realized, wow, you can buy one soundtrack, like, say, I don't know, Lalo Schifrin or Quincy Jones, eh? And you can hear within one record, you know, a rock cue, a jazz cue, an orchestral cue. To me, it was like one of the most eclectic listening experiences that I'd ever had. I think even in the 50s, it was starting to change. You know, the old guard, like the Max Steiners and the, you know, these kind of guys, even the Elmer Bernsteins were starting to die out. But, I mean, even Elmer Bernstein, I mean, come on. Yes, he's considered, I guess, an orchestral composer. But look at The Man with the Golden Arm. That's a jazz score. The thing that I liked about film music is that there didn't seem to be, it was polluted already. When I discovered it, it was polluted, meaning, I mean that in a good sense, meaning there were all sorts of influences. Like even on an early Bernstein score, you can find a bossa nova cue or, maybe a twist or, you know what I mean? They were using the idioms of the time. One of the biggest revelations that I had was hearing Morricone scores to, you know, the Leone movies, and then watching how that music worked with the image, and that is what fucked me up. Morricone's music, of course, is amazing, but the way Leone used it and the way he wrote, I read books about it afterwards, the way that he wrote scenes around the music, let the music be composed first, and then cut scenes around the music. To me, I don't know why more directors don't do that. For some reason, Peter Thomas is kind of frowned upon in the film music community, and I'm not sure why. I thought, when I first heard the Juan Patol 60s sci-fi series that he did, I was flat on my ass. I think that it'd be easy for a lot of film music, you know, critics or community to look at it as kitsch. And I think that's a complete mistake. I don't listen to music that way, you know? There you have it. Oh, it's very Lalo Schifrin.
I can scarcely believe the event.
I'm composing for right now for a kind of a crazy action movie. So, you know, the directors want things that are very hyper and very fast-paced and, you know, more often than not, very rock-oriented. So, you know, I can do that. Actually, I can do that with, like, in my sleep. But what I'm trying to do is sneak in some influences that I have, and John Barry would definitely be one of them. I think that cue, I don't know if I played you this cue. Here, come here. This cue to me is like a six-note motif that is very, to me, John Barry. When the main theme kicks in, it's like, even the instrumentation. John Barry.